I'm Mike Bowers, Group Legal Director at TUI Travel PLC. That means I'm responsible for all of the group legal services across the group, and I'm also responsible for looking after our political affairs, so engaging with stakeholders and politicians to make sure our voice is heard as industry leader. So we're talking about the regulatory framework for our industry. What's really important for our industry, our travel industry, and how that should look in the future. The piece of legislation, the Package Travel Directive, has got out of date. And what we need to avoid going into the next 5, 10, 15, 20 years is that happens again. We need to look at the scope of who's covered. We need to expand that scope to bring all of those people who are really booking holidays back within scope. In 1990, when the original Package Travel Directive was introduced, the holiday landscape was far different than it is today. The market was entirely different. No low-cost carriers. The internet was still something for the future. And so everything was more or less covered by the Package Travel Directive. Over time, of course, that part of the market that's covered by the directive has become smaller and smaller as a proportion of the whole, because people are doing booking holidays in vastly different ways, ways that were never thought of, which means there's plenty of customers out there now who are booking holidays without all of those protections. That's where we are today, and what the Commission have said is, well, look, we need to do something about that. We need to look at the scope of who's covered. We need to expand that scope to bring all of those people who are really booking holidays back within scope. And actually, you know, they've done a pretty good job. They've looked at that market, they've expanded, or they're proposing to expand the scope, and they've said, well, you know, if you book something that broadly resembles a holiday, then that's going to be a package. What they've also done, though, is introduced another category called assisted travel arrangements. It's quite difficult to understand what's really within it and what it really means. And that's going to be confusing for customers. And it's actually going to be confusing for industry as well to know whether they're in that first category of package or that other category of assisted travel arrangements. What we would have liked to have seen from the Commission, and where we will still urge the Council of Ministers and the European Parliament to get to, is just two different categories, either a full protected package or no protection at all. And then there will be much greater clarity for customers. They'll understand that either they've booked a package and they get the full range of protections, or they've booked a set of arrangements that actually don't have any protections, and that's a valid choice too. The benefits to industry of a principles-based approach is that as business models change, and as we all start to do business in a different way with all the innovations that we want to embrace coming forward, it will mean that we have certainty and clarity over which sorts of arrangements are covered by the directive. And if we have a principles-based approach, we'll know that whenever we're selling broadly a holiday in a customer's own terms, then that arrangement will be covered by the directive.